Good morning.
Good morning.
Here's your pride. And if I sound a little nasal, it's because I am. Dr. Hickman and I have been back and forth to DC in the last week and a half twice. But let me just say thank you to President Obama and your administration, because you are the key to the success of the students here at Alabama State University. So I'm just proud that you are SGA President. Thank you for that introduction. Protocol hasn't been established today, and I'm going to take my time because I've got a lot of emotions running right now. I'm reminiscing of one of my favorite movies, which was The Wings. Diana Ross and the late Michael Jackson. If you know about The Wizard of Oz or The Wiz, Dorothy would always click her heels and say that there's no place like home. So I'm clicking my heels today because there's no place like home. To our presiding officer, Dr. Pettis, to say it's you. And let me say something about Dr. Wilson. Because in times of distress, and in times of need, you have to have someone to step forward, to steady the ship, to hold it in the road. And Dr. Wilson, you've done that. And I just want to thank you. And as Dr. Hayward has already established, I would be remiss if I did not mention devastating attack that took place yesterday in Las Vegas. Because see, as we're in this place, in this space, we have to thank God that He is providing a covering over us. And so I just ask all of you to think about those individuals and the victims that suffered yesterday. But also to think about our brothers and sisters in Puerto Rico and in the places that have been devastated by the storms. We have to keep them in our hearts and in our minds and do whatever we can to lift them up, because they're going through something that none of us have ever experienced, and we have to keep them lifted in prayer and in deed. I want to say at this time that I want to thank God for this opportunity. And some have heard me say it before, but it is only the master architect that could design a moment such as this. For a young man that was born in Mobile, Alabama, and taken to Michigan and raised and brought back to go to Alabama State University. I'll never forget my parents dropping me off with a little trunk and leaving me. But it would only have been at that time, and by God's design, that I would serve as a freshman class senator for Card Hall. But then I would go on to become one of 8 black state senators in the state of Alabama, under God's design. Could do that. It would only be by God's design that I stand here as the 15th president of Alabama State University, but the first time that I was president was as SGA president on this campus. So God is an awesome God. And he truly has blessed me. And so I thank God for giving me the opportunity at this time, in this moment, in history and during our Sesquicentennial centennial to stand as the 15th president of Alabama State University. We spent some time in Washington last week as we celebrated the 150 years of 9 universities. I cannot express to you how proud I was to sit on Thursday night in a joint choir with students from all 9 colleges. And Dr. Sanchez, I have to tell you that you have to be proud of the students that were there representing us. We had 2 of our students who sing solos, but Ms. Zabril Rivers, Ms. Courtney Ellis, Matthew Chappelle, and Janae Bowen. When I tell you that their voices sung out in the Morgan State University auditorium, and there were ASU grads that were there, but you can feel it in your soul State University, representing the world. And I just want to give these young people a round of applause. Now, secondly, I'd like to thank Chairwoman Green and the entire Board of Trustees, the Presidential Search Committees, the students, the community members, alumni, faculty, and staff for this unique opportunity to stand here as the 15th president of Alabama State University. But you know, finally, I would like to thank my family and friends who have supported me and believed in me as I embarked upon this new journey in my life. But more importantly, I'd like to give a special thanks to my mother and my father, Mrs. Shirley A. Ross and Quinton T. Ross Sr., because it had not been for them, 1968 grad, 1969 grad of Alabama State University, I wouldn't be here today. So I want to salute them and thank them for, even when I was in the womb, I knew that I was going to be a student at Alabama State University. So this year, as we celebrate ASU's 150th year of existence, it is natural to reflect on struggles and the sacrifice that our institution has endured, that it can remain for the students of today and those yet unborn. And the struggle was not easy. And when you look at 150 years, that is a long time. And in all of that time, no matter what the issue, no matter what the circumstance, Alabama State University stood and is still standing. And when we think about its history, nine black slaves, known as the Marion Nine, that stood strong with just $500 and changed all of our lives on July 18, 1867, when these nine gentlemen made up a board of trustees and formed a corporation called the Lincoln Stoop of Merit. And so when you think about it, you think about Joe Pitch and Thomas Speed and Nicholas Dale and James Chimes and Thomas Lee and John Freeman and Nathan LeVert, Ivy Parrish, and Alexander H. Curtis, who happened to be a black state senator in the early 1800s in Alabama. Those nine men had it in their minds to prepare a way for us to make sure that we would continue to make our mark known and impact this world like never before. And so we should be proud of our history. We should be proud of the Marion Nine. And we should walk around, and every time we think about the opportunities that we have and things that we have achieved, we have to give them just due. Because when I think about all that I have and all that I've accomplished in my life, ASU has been at the forefront of all my successes. And when I talk about success, and when we talk about acknowledging the legacy of our rich history, we must today cultivate our collective efforts, and I'll repeat that, our collective efforts, and think about 150 years forward. 150 years forward. You see, because we must realize that a lot of blood, sweat, and tears were shed to afford us this opportunity to learn and grow and even lead for 150 years. Moving ASU forward for 150 more years may not involve blood, sweat, and tears, but it will definitely involve perseverance, collaboration, diligence, compliance, and even sometimes a little sweat. Together, we must ask ourselves the question, what is it that we will do going forward to sustain and preserve Old Mother Dear for another 150 years? For children born and yet unborn, who will aspire to become a part of our ASU family 150 years forward? And so we have to ask ourselves the question, What is it that we will do? We must now work to assess our overall academic enterprise and to ensure the viability of our institution. We must prepare our students, present, future, for the ever-changing global society. We must stand and expand ASU's footprint in the global academy throughout the 21st century and beyond. The time is now. The time is now we must evaluate our values, our thinking, our customer service to levels that we've never seen before. We must establish a new normal of care and service, putting students first. We must mold the behavior we expect, and we must serve pleasantly and professionally at all times, without any exception. I talk to my 8-year-old son, and I tell him that please and thank you, or how may I help you? These are universal words and expressions that let people know that Alabama State University is open for business and ready. Ready to serve. Every time we answer the phone here at Alabama State University, thank you for calling ASU. How may I help you? Plus, every phone call that's made to Alabama State University should be answered, and every message left should be responded to. That we are here to serve our students and provide them an educational experience of our time. Our student is our most precious resource, and they can help tell our story. So we have to shadow ourselves to understand that without the students, this institution does not exist. And as we talk about existence, I read an article a few days ago. There were some 127 historical black colleges in this country. We're down to 107. And the article suggested that there should be only 50. So again, I ask you, if we had to make a decision, where would Alabama State be in that 50? Would we be there? So we have to channel our minds and our energies to doing what's going to make us go and propel us forward for another 150 years. We must create a cultural climate and climate of shared ideas to chart a path forward for the next 150 years. We must share in the governance of our ASU. This starts with the reality that ASU boards of trustees and faculty and all share a commitment to providing students with a quality education that delivers results. We all want the same thing, don't we? Don't we? We all want the same thing. We all want ASU to be successful. We want our students to be successful. So if we can agree on that, then nothing, no one, should be able to stand in our way. We want ASU students to learn and grow and thrive while they're here. We want our undergraduates to graduate in 4 years or 5 years or less. They have to graduate. And when they graduate, they have to go to work. And we have to work to ensure that. We want our graduate students to engage in world-class professional programs that offer the opportunity to contribute to research and scholarship. And we want everyone to maintain the fervent commitment to working together and always serving Alabama State University. We all are part of this university family. Every person here today, and those that are not, for once a Hornet, always a Hornet. And together we will forge a shared vision for the 150 years to come, 150 years forward. The time is now. Realizing that the students of yesterday is much different from the student of today and will be much different from the student of tomorrow, we must provide meaningful professional development opportunities for our faculty and staff to adjust, to prepare for the future. We must mentor and research, guide and scholarship, and groom instructional strategies. Because if we do not prepare to adapt to change, we will not exist in the next 150 years. 150 years forward, the time is now. We must walk collectively to ensure that the basic expectations of our students are met. A safe campus, proper campus housing, a clean campus.